With that, I guess, let's see. Kim, do you want to maybe share the, I was going to go over some programming highlights for the chamber. I think, do you have a screen share for that, or am I just going to talk about it? Ah, there we go. So even in the midst of the current situation, I think you guys have probably seen that the chamber is remaining sort of hyperactive. You know, we are by far the most active chamber of commerce in South Florida, with more events, more networking opportunities than any other, I would say any other organization in the Tri-County area. So I think you guys made a great decision in joining the Gables Chamber. There really is something for everybody. Our vice president, Kim Benkover, who's controlling the screen, just put up a list of upcoming events. As you can see, even without the ability to meet in person, we're not slowing down. We're trying to keep a lot of programming available for you all. And even though we're meeting virtually, it's still a great chance to see one another and network a bit and keep up to date on all things chamber and in the community. I can tell you that Mark Trowbridge, our president, has been one of the leading voices in the county, along with a lot of our other civic and community leaders throughout this process. He's been called on for interviews, and I can say that this past Tuesday, we did a virtual fly-in with the U.S. Chamber of Commerce in Washington, D.C. Typically, this time of the year, our chamber does an actual fly-in with about between 15 and 20 people to Washington to visit our elected officials, and also a lot of the federal agencies that exist in D.C. We always meet with the U.S. Chamber, and they told us that we were the very first Chamber of Commerce in the U.S. to do this sort of a program with them, and they were going to use it as a model for other chambers around the U.S. So that gives you an idea about the way that we're sort of leading the charge with this. We are absolutely leading the charge. So I'm proud to say that the chamber has not sat idle for even a day during this entire situation. And we're going to continue, and we're going to lead the way out of it as well, I can say, I think, in the city of Coral Gables. So let's see. You guys see the events. There are lots of opportunities to participate. These are all free, and you guys are all encouraged, whatever relates to your industries, or if you just want to join to hear and to be around some other people, please do. We can accommodate up to 100 participants through our Zoom account with any of these events, and we've had some large ones, so I hope you guys join in on those if you haven't already. So the chamber is in the process right now. We're coordinating with the city of Coral Gables. We've been talking with other chambers around South Florida about spearheading a reopening, a business reopening task force for the city of Coral Gables. So you may be hearing more about that, but we're trying to bring in as many community stakeholder organizations as we can to participate. And I think it only makes sense that the city of Coral Gables looks to the Chamber of Commerce to lead the way in how our small businesses and our entire business community approach the reopening, which hopefully we'll be seeing sooner rather than later. I'm sure you all agree with me on that. The sooner the better. So this is the point in the presentation where typically we have our sponsor, Amerant Bank, come on and say a few words. I don't see Hernan Milan on the call. I can tell you that Amerant has been a great partner with us for Chamber 101 for the last couple of years. They typically provide us with breakfast. Sorry you guys aren't getting breakfast this morning, but they are gem level members of the Chamber of Commerce, which is our top level of membership. And they've been just very good, engaged participants with us for many years. And we appreciate them continuing with their sponsorship of Chamber 101. So if Hernan comes comes in, or one of his colleagues from Ameren pop into the meeting in the over the next 45 minutes or so, we'll ask him to say a few words of introduction, if that works. So looking at our group that we have here this morning, we do have another member of our executive committee on the call. Nicholas Aterovic is our vice chair of membership. You just want to wave, Nicholas. And
hey, Project, I do want to say, I do want to welcome everyone. And I know you touched on the fly-in, DC fly-in. I wanted to say what an amazing, incredible event that was. I've been going to DC with Patrick and a few others, maybe the last 3-4 years. And I cannot tell you how impressed I was from not being in DC actually and just doing this on virtually. It was amazing. So kudos to the chamber.
Thanks, Nicholas. You want to go ahead and do your self-introduction and we'll just roll into that from, you can leave that off.
I'm sorry to break the chain there.
No, it's good. It's perfect. It's a great segue. So go ahead.
Okay. Hi, everyone. This is Nicholas Aterovic. I'm a financial advisor with Edward Jones. I'm also the member of Ferris Chair for the Chamber on the Executive Committee this year. Proud to serve. Membership is so dear to my heart. I mean, it's really the way to really get to know people in the Chamber. Patrick talked about and the different events that Kim has put on the screen. I mean, there's so many ways to meet people and get in touch with people. I mean, there's obviously now everything is free, which is amazing that the chamber is doing that. But during the regular season, there's a lot of paid events, but there's a lot of free things you can do at the chamber. For example, joining committees and everything, and really is something that I think this Chamber 101, we're really trying to hold your hand here and show you a little bit of these things. But there's a little bit of everything for everyone, and not everything is for everyone. So just you guys, you have me here and the rest of the team, make sure you ask us any questions you have and how you get the best out of the Chamber and in these unusual times as well. Thank you.
Great. Thank you, Nicholas. So I guess in no particular order, or actually, why don't we go down the order that exists right now in the chat for introductions. So let's see. Why don't we begin with Juan Villamil from AAA Insurance. Hi, Juan. So give us your name, your company, and go ahead.
Thank you so much for having us here. I know that the Coral Gables Chamber of Commerce was not behind. Then I saw this opportunity to have this type of meetings, approaching all the what the technology is giving for us at this unprecedented time. And one of the things that I really appreciate to be in this chamber, that we are taking every advantage that we can have. Well, everybody, thank you so much for being here. My name is Juan Villasmil. I represent AAA Insurance. Okay, AAA is an organization that has been for more than 100 years in the market. I specifically belong to the insurance department. We work for exclusively to our members for homeowners, car, and also other type of specialty insurances. But I do also, I am the representative for AAA in the city of Coral Gables. So it means that everything related with a AAA membership, I will be the representative for any type of business, or in this case, any type of particular person that would like to take advantage of the benefits of AAA during this area.
Wonderful. Thank you, Juan. I appreciate that. So let's go to Win Kamania, if I said that correctly.
Julian, good morning, everybody. Thank you for having the 101 today. I'm very happy to be here. I see a few familiar faces from either in the past as a member or, like, for example, Yvette and Mr. Aterovic as well. And also some of the events that, as you mentioned right now, the chamber has been amazing throughout this time. we are still able to see everybody and to share and do the networking that we are so interested in doing. And it's been great. The Washington event was superb, actually. I represent DLE Legal Services here in On Coral Way. We do court reporting and process serving. So for, you know, all the, my target would be the attorneys from all around. And I'm happy to be here. And again, thank you very much for having the one-on-one today.
Great, thank you. And let's go to Lee Lennon with Travel by Design. Hi, Lee. Oh, we need to unmute.
Good morning. Yeah, good morning. Thank you. Hello, everybody. My name is Lee Lennon, and this is my very first meeting with the Chamber, and I've been wanting to join. So I look forward to meeting all of you again in person, hopefully one day. My company is Travel by Design. I'm located in Coral Gables. I am a home-based agency. I've been in living in Coral Gables actually for almost 30 years, but I worked in corporate prior. Our company specializes in customized travel experiences for guests. So we don't do a lot of huge group business, but everything is very customized. We're part of the Virtuoso community, and I look forward to being able to meet everyone. And actually, I love Coral Gables, and just to be able to work with the community itself and get to know more people and get to know how we can, or as a group, continue to make its city beautiful as well. I'm also a member of the Villagers Preservation. So we usually are very involved. So I look forward to meeting you, and thank you for having me here.
Great, thank you, Lee. Let's go to Stephanie Zeverino with Belmont Village Senior Living. It's a great project. I'm looking forward to seeing that rise out of the ground. So Stephanie.
Yeah, you can imagine. Good morning, everyone. I'm Director of Business Development for Belmont Village Senior Living. You can imagine what we're doing as a company to keep our 30 communities across the country and keep our residents safe and away from this horrible virus. But I'm fortunate here in Fort Lauderdale. I relocated a year and a half ago from Los Angeles. I've been with Belmont 9 years, and I spent 23 years in LA, and moved here, like I said, a year and a half ago to help brand and market us in Fort Lauderdale in Broward County. And my responsibility is to, as we open new communities such as Coral Gables, which will be open late 2021, I will be then moving over into the Coral Gables market to do the same to help brand and develop us in the Coral Gables market. I have to tell you, I'm not familiar at all with Miami and Coral Gables. I had to very quickly dive in and understand Broward County and the healthcare community here, but we in Coral Gables have a little bit of an advantage with our joint venture with Baptist Health. So I think some of you may have heard Patricia Will, my CEO. She presented the senior housing industry at large to the Coral Gables Chamber breakfast meeting. I think that was back in, I want to say
January.
Was it January?
That was our January breakfast, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. So it's a wonderful project. I'm excited to start to kind of dabble in Coral Gables. I don't know when that will be. I have to get Fort Lauderdale up and running, and then I'll start to move over and get to know all of you a little bit more closely. So thank you.
Wonderful. Looking forward to hearing more about it as well. And let's go to Pilar Socaras. Pilar, Keller Williams, yes? Commercial. Just need to unmute. There we go.
Hello, everyone. Yes, Pilar Socaras from Keller Williams in the commercial and residential real estate. There's a lot of questions everyone has. What's going to happen with the economy? Are we going into a recession? What's going to happen with real estate? What's going to happen with all the commercial real estate? What's going to happen with malls, what's going to happen with restaurants. It's really going to depend on when things start opening up and how people are going to feel going out again. We do know that it's not the same as 2008. In 2008, we had a financial crisis. There was a lot of inventory of things. Right now, the inventory and the demand for inventory at this moment, it's not, it's about the same. We do think that it's going to turn out as time goes by, that there's going to be more buyers that are going to be out there. But it's still a good time to buy or sell, if that is what you are interested in doing, because of the low interest rates that we have. If you wait to buy something later on and the interest rates go up, for every point that that the interest rates go up, you will lose 10% of buying power. But it's going to be, especially the commercial part of real estate, is going to be a very interesting how it's all going to play out with how people have been working from home. When people start going back to work, are they going to change how they're organizing the offices? Are they going to make sure that people are 6 feet apart? How are the business owners going to do to protect their employees and get people back together again? So it's going to be very interesting.
Thank you, Pilar. Yeah, those are a lot of big questions, and hopefully it'll become clearer as we get closer to that day of reopening. I'll go to Tanya Reed. Hi, Tanya.
Good morning, everyone. I am happy to be here. I'm Tanya Reed with Focal Point Business Coaching. I'm a strategic business advisor, and I help CEOs and business owners work through all the financial management issues that come with running a business. So I help them, coach them through that to make sure the business is sound and stable before moving to the next level. As you can imagine, at this point, I'm pretty busy helping clients to navigate the COVID funding that's available, and that isn't the most intuitive or the easiest to figure out. So I've been spending a lot of time doing that and sharing information, and also helping clients to manage their cash flow during this crisis, which is number one in every business owner's mind at this point. So it's been quite the roller coaster so far, but I'm glad that I'm able to use my experience and expertise to help them and add value in that way. I joined the chamber, I want to say at the end of January, but wasn't able to make the previous chamber 101. So I'm happy that this is happening today so I can learn how to navigate the chamber more effectively. And although I live and work in Coconut Grove, I spend most of my time over in the Gables. So again, happy to be here and to meet everyone.
Great. Thank you, Tanya. I appreciate it. Let's go to Marcelino Hernandez.
Hey, hello, everybody. My name is Marcelino Hernandez, and I'm with Beacons of South Florida. This is my first meeting with you guys. We just joined the chamber. So thanks for having us aboard with you guys. Glad to be here. I represent a moving and storage company, and we've been around locally for 50 years. The name Beacons itself has been around since 1891. We're literally the oldest moving company. I work hand in hand with a lot of realtors in the area. I'm the Dade County representative, so I cover anywhere from North Miami all the way down to Key Largo. And I also work hand in hand. We are a silver certified company. So we deal with seniors. We're actually the only moving company locally suited to deal with senior move managers and senior facilities. So I thought that'd be good for some work with Stephanie over there. So I'm glad to be here, guys. I'm all in on this. I'm really excited to be part of this group, and I look forward to get to know all you guys and grow within the chamber, and hopefully have a lot of work with you guys and help you guys any way that I can. I'm here, and thank you. Thank you very much.
Thanks for joining, Marcelino. Appreciate it. Let's go to Leo McRae.
Hey, good morning. How are you?
morning.
Hey. So my name is Leo. As you mentioned, I'm with the Verizon Wireless Business Group. And what I do is that I specialize in corporate accounts in the 10 through 500 employee space. The city of Coral Gables is my territory. There's only one of me. But I also have assigned the Coconut Grove area and also Metro Miami that extends down to downtown Miami through 57th Avenue. So my team handles everything that is south of West Palm Beach. We're just specifically targeting in smaller areas. So if you need anything, whether you have a branch here or somewhere in West Palm Beach, you let me know and then I can get you guys in touch with the right people. I'm very happy to hear that all of you guys are doing well and how you guys are thriving during this crisis. It's great to see everybody using technology to help their businesses move forward. And that's probably the best thing that that has come out of all of this is how everybody can still manage to connect and still manage to do all the things that they need to do to make their businesses thrive by utilizing the technology that we've come up with. So that's awesome. If there's anything that I can be of any help, I'm not going to take up anybody's time today. My email is in the chat. You guys can feel free to reach out to me. And that's it. Thank you guys so much for this opportunity.
Thank you, Leo. Appreciate that. Let's go to, this is one of my colleagues, David Schulwitz. Dave.
Hey, can you hear me?
Yep, you're there.
Hey, good morning, everyone. I'm super happy to be here. I'm looking forward to hopefully meeting in person soon. Today, you get me in my T-shirt and Dolphins hat. So like Stephanie said, I believe, I've been in Miami, not my whole life, only a couple years now. I got to Miami in June of 18, but I absolutely love it here. I'm a warm weather guy. Happy to be here. Originally grew up in Michigan. But anyways, I'm joining the Coral Gables Chamber of Commerce, not only for the business connections, but hoping to, you know, meet some people to be friends with and just to know in the community as well. So looking forward to meeting you guys. I'm a realtor, like Patrick said, at EWM Realty at the South Miami Coral Gables office on South Dixie Highway. I'm also an investor. I've been buying ugly properties and fixing them up and being a landlord for about 10 years now. So if anyone has any interest or, you know, I can talk real estate all day as far as investing and things like that. So if you just want to be a real estate nerd with me, I'm always down for that. Absolutely. Also a veteran. If there's any other veterans out there, fun little thing to talk about as well. And lastly, I'm a sports fan. Not sure if anyone's excited about, we got Tua last night coming to Miami, so should be fun. Anyways, really looking forward to getting to know all you guys in person. Hopefully we can strike some business and strike some friendships out of this.
Great. Thank you, Dave. Appreciate it. So let's go to Jillian Hornick from Jays, perhaps the longest ongoing business on Miracle Mile ever, maybe.
And let's keep it that way, right?
Yeah, for sure.
Hi, everyone. My name is Jill. I am the third generation owner and operator of our family's business, Jay's Jewelers. This year, we're celebrating 75 years, but based upon what is going on right now, it looks like we're only maybe going to get about a quarter of the year in business. So I have been working tirelessly from my home, getting us technologically advanced. Luckily, we already had an e-commerce website in place, and that has been our lifeline the past month and a half. But we are also on other websites that are international for art and jewelry, and watches. So that has helped quite a bit as well. We only have 6 employees, and I'm hoping to keep it that way. The PPP money should be hitting our bank account today or Monday, so fingers crossed it all works out. Shout out to Ocean Bank for stepping up when our other bank couldn't come through. So yeah, and if there's anything anybody needs for birthdays, anniversaries, Mother's Day, we're still doing our sales via online methods, or you can call me or email me, and I will sit and talk with you through whatever your options may be. And we're doing free nationwide shipping or free delivery in Miami-Dade County.
Wonderful. Thank you, Jillian. Nice to see you.
Good to see you.
Oh, I see Flavia Berti is here from Equipause as well. Do you want to do a quick intro? Flavia.
Good morning. Thank you, Patrick. My name is Flavia. I am the owner of Equipause Pet Services. We keep Miami's pets fit, healthy, and happy. As you all know, right now, we are probably not, you know, at our level of normal business, but we're trying to help those that really need us at the moment. I have been a member for several years now, and I'm part of the Women's Business Networking Luncheon Committee, and I love it. I, you know, highly encourage everybody to join a committee because it's fantastic, but I never did the 101, so I wanted to join and see what it was all about so I can have more resources and meet more people. So welcome, everybody.
Thank you, Flavia. Nice to see you. Let's see, a couple that I missed. Eva Long.
Sorry, I'm logged on twice, just so you know, it's a double log on.
It's okay. Oh yeah, you're gonna have to maybe mute your phone or mute your computer, one of the two.
Yeah, I muted the computer to zero. Let me.
There we go. We can hear you. Go ahead.
Okay. I was working with Christina at Intermedia Touch. We do digital signage. They have the hand sanitizers on the side of that. So it's the interactive touchscreen type of things. In the interim, since obviously things are a little bit slow in certain industries now, I just started working with a company the last 2 weeks to distribute the N95, K95, and 3-ply masks in case anybody needs. They're all from FDA and European Union certified factories. So they're taking orders. I actually have to get an order in by 5 today for a plane that's leaving in 10 days from there, and they have another shipment coming in by boat. But if anyone needs, I figured, I've been to a number of the in-person events, and it's always been very lovely. So it's interesting to see this new dynamic come together really quickly with the virtual meetings. So thanks, everyone.
Glad you could join us. Thank you. So T. Berquist, I don't have your name in the chat, I don't believe, but go ahead if you want to do a quick intro.
Sure, that's okay. My name's actually difficult to pronounce if you're just looking at it anyways. It's Tia, it's spelled T-I-I-J-A. So I am one of the sales managers for Office Edge and Legal Edge Services. It used to be a few months back Alexis Ekberg, and so I took over for Alexis a little bit ago. But we're a full service executive office. We provide not only fully equipped offices, we're in the Coral Gables Collection building, but we also have just a bevy of business solutions for different companies, everything from professional mailing address to receptionist services to conference room time, virtual administrative assistance. We also have a sister company called Legal Edge Services, where we provide a lot of services virtually now, such as virtual notarization, virtual paralegal support. Obviously, outside of COVID, a lot of this was also face-to-face. We do have specific and special mediation rates for attorneys. So pretty much what we're doing is just trying to, curtail our service plan to the market right now, knowing that it's temporary, but kind of thinking outside of the box and looking to offer services to people on a 30-day, 60-day, and 90-day basis that can help help them sustain their business while they're working from home during this time.
Wonderful. Thank you. Glad you could join us as well. There are a couple of members of the chamber staff with us. Yvette Acosta, I don't know if you just want to say hello or wave, and Kim Bentcover, who's kind of, there we go, there's Yvette, hello, and Kim. And so we're going to start the program. I'm going to speak for a few minutes. We're going to hear from Lauren Dahlin. Lauren, do you want to do your intro when you begin your section of the...
Whatever is most efficient, Patrick.
Okay, yeah, why don't you do your intro, and then followed by Caleb Blake from University of Miami, you can do your little intro then too, I guess, right? So perfect. Okay, so Kim, if you want to switch over to the slides, we'll roll through this, I guess, pretty quickly. And if you guys have questions, maybe I guess we save those till the end. I think it's pretty straightforward. So welcome to Chamber 101 orientation, sponsored by Amerant Bank. Hopefully they'll be joining us here at some point or another. You can go ahead and forward the slide, Kim, if you like. So Chamber of Commerce, I mentioned a little bit at the top of the meeting about, you know, how involved we are, the all of the events that we do. We are a 501c6 organization. We're a non-profit company that's been in existence basically since the beginning of Coral Gables. Our first chairman was George E. Merrick back in 1925. So we're looking forward to our 100-year anniversary coming up really in just, you know, a short 4.5 years or so. 800 member companies, 1,600 individuals among those 800 companies. That number may be even a little bit higher than 800, to be honest with you. I think we're probably closer to 850. And as you can see at the bottom of the screen there, our mission statement, which was just redone about 2 years ago, is to advance business success and member engagement in Coral Gables and beyond through our commitment to inclusiveness, relevancy, and integrity. And I think as you get to know us, you'll find that we do a pretty good job of delivering on that mission. So as far as your personal, your company's investment in the chamber, this is like a gym membership. If you don't show up, if you don't go, you're not going to get the results that you're looking for. It really is a person-to-person experience. And I think that I've found over the many years I've been involved that the business that I've gotten out of the chamber, it's not like you go around and you have to ask for it. You really don't. You get to know people through committee involvement and through being present at a lot of our events. People get to know you and the business follows. It's just a natural progression that happens as you get involved and stay involved with our chamber. So that pretty much, let's see, we obviously right now all of our programming is virtual, as I mentioned before. And so please do get involved with the virtual stuff. It's free. And I hope that you join in when you can. And I think you'll begin to see some familiar faces. And it's going to be, I think, interesting after a few months of this virtual experience, getting to see people in person again. And I think there'll be a lot of first-time in-person meetings at a certain point when we're able to start returning to those programs. But I think that's it for me. I'm passing it on to Lauren Dahlin with Lowell International Realty. Lauren, do you want to do your intro?
Hi.
And then
Thank
take it
you.
Over?
Thanks, Patrick. My name is Lauren Dahlin. I'm a residential realtor with Lowell International Realty. We're a boutique concierge-style firm located here in Coral Gables. We specialize in relocations and those moving to our city beautiful and helping to plug those families and individuals into the community. But we also service basically every neighborhood kind of south of the Brickell area. So that's me. I'm also, on behalf of the chamber, I volunteer as the chair of the Ambassador Committee. Now the Ambassador Committee would be reaching out to you during this time. And if you haven't heard from your ambassador as a new member yet, then Kim, maybe you can help me with that. The ambassadors are here to welcome you, to guide you, and to help answer your questions. We're usually the friendly face that meets you at the monthly breakfast meeting and various events throughout the month. But we're here for you now as well, virtually. In fact, I just had a Zoom coffee meeting with one of the new members in the chamber, and that was really fun. So I encourage you to reach out to your ambassador if you haven't heard from them yet, or me. Okay, that's me. Organizational chart. As you can see, the board of directors is made up of all volunteers, including as well as the staff member and the president and CEO, Mark Trowbridge. And then we have various subcommittees that fall under the board, and as a whole, this makes up the volunteer leadership of the chamber. It changes from year to year, and I think we saw September? Right, September is when our leadership changes. So we have different buckets, as you can kind of see, and
I don't think I need to go too far into those. You're going to get to know the various events and committees that fall under those buckets. Here's your chamber team. These are the amazing staff members that work on behalf of the chamber. They are here for you anytime to answer any questions and are extremely knowledgeable about the membership as well. So if you can't remember who's who, just reach out to that person on the chamber that maybe you know the best, and they'll put you in the right direction. So Director of Events and Programs is Erica Simons. Our Communications Manager is Morgan. Director of Finance and Operations is Yvette, and she's on the call too. You've already met, I think, our Vice President, Kim Bentcover. And then Ileana Delgado is somebody that you'll really want to get to know because she helps you with a lot of the membership-related questions and what's have you. And then our membership sales representative you probably have already met, and that's Leo Fernandez. So that's the chamber team. Here's some of those buckets a little bit clearly for you. So the chairman's division is underneath Patrick O'Connell. These are the different subcommittees that fall under each of these buckets. So there's a Good Morning Coral Gables, strategic planning, a travel and tourism, which is not very active right this minute, but I think it'll probably be an interesting topic to explore in the coming year. And a restaurant committee that is chaired by Stephen Bradley of Clutch Burger. So they're very active, actually. The business and economic development bucket is chaired by Sarah Hernandez. There's an awesome women's business network that produces a luncheon every month. And when we get back rolling, I highly encourage all of you to attend that monthly luncheon. It's great speakers, great networking. They host an annual Business Woman of the Year Awards, and there's also a small business committee, which has also been very active of recent. Under our community affairs area, we have Vice Chair Mike Ibarra. There's a business and education subcommittee. That's an interesting one because business and education really have a lot to do with each other and a very happy relationship in the city of Coral Gables. So there's an annual breakfast that brings together these two groups. Dennis Lindsay is the chair of that committee. And if you have an interest in seeing how your business can get involved on the education sector or vice versa, I highly encourage you to check that out. And then we have a really active young professional group. It's called the 2030 Group. And they have a fun one every month called Wind Down Wednesday. And they've been doing that via Zoom as well. So look for the emails to participate with the 2030 group. Under the Global of Business Affairs, the vice chair is Renee Negron. We have Flags on Ponce, which is a really neat program through the chamber. If you remember driving down Ponce de Leon Boulevard in Coral Gables, there's many, many flags representing many countries, and businesses can actually sponsor those flags, and it kind of leads to the international community that we have within Coral Gables. We do have sister cities. Coral Gables has official sister cities. I think there's three of them. And then also I think every other year the chamber hosts a Gables Global Groove, in which they invite ambassadors from different countries and representatives business-wise. And that's a really interesting and unique opportunity. Under Member Affairs, you've met Nicholas, who's our Vice Chair. We have a Trustee Council, so if you're a trustee member of the Chamber, you're going to hear from Eric Rodebois. The Membership Team, which helps to recruit and retain members, is led by Kayla Blake, and you're going to hear from her in a minute. Chairman Ambassadors is me. And then the Reconnect Luncheon, which I highly suggest also when we're back up and running that everybody try to attend at least one of these throughout the year if they sell out quickly. And it's a great networking opportunity the first Wednesday of every month. Special events, the Chamber does a great job of hosting these and they're very popular. The New Year's Networker is not to be missed. It's usually the first or second week in January. I'm telling you, it is not to be missed. There's probably 1,000 people at that event. The Doctors Hospital 5K is usually in April, but that'll be postponed. And we have a chairman's reception once we get started back at the chamber new year in September. Burgerlicious. Kayla's going to tell you a little bit more about that later. And then under our Government and Legislative Affairs Committee, the Vice Chair is Efren Sora. There's a Business and Government Affairs Committee, and that's very interesting. A lot of you probably would find that helpful to your business. And then there's a Public Policy Task Force, so that I think is on hold for now. So is that it for the divisions and committees, Kim? Okay. And am I doing member benefits? I'm sorry. Yes, I am. Okay. So there's lots of opportunities for you to utilize that membership that you've just invested in with the chamber. And Patrick is exactly right. You're going to get more out of the chamber that you put in. So communications wise, you're going to look for the chamber connection that comes out bi-monthly. The chamber e-com comes out monthly, weekly, I believe, as well as the chamber chatter. I can't remember when the usage goes. Lots of newsletters from the chamber. Check them out. Make sure you read them all because there's lots of different upcoming events and opportunities to get involved. There's a member-to-member discount program, which you can reach out to Ileana Delgado, and she'll tell you more about that. But you can offer a discount to members, and that's a great way to get the word out about your business, as well as there's opportunities to partner with the chamber on the social media. There are several member recognition awards. I'm sorry, guys. We're just having problems logging onto school real quick. Member recognition award programs, the Diamond Awards, Business Women of the Year Awards, Rising Star, which is coming up, City Beautiful Awards, and the George E. Merrick Awards of Excellence. These are great opportunities to not only highlight and showcase maybe some clients, or prospective clients, or people that are important to you, maybe they employees, but they are also a way for you to get your name out about your business, and self-nominations for these various award programs are welcome. So that's kind of look out for annual awards. Okay, ambassador, mentors, and trustee diplomats. So that's the committee that I get to be a part of. And these are selected by the leadership, by the chairman. We're all volunteers. And I would highly recommend you seeking out some kind of committee involvement, whether it's through the various divisions and committees that I just discussed, or perhaps one day you'll be an ambassador or a trustee diplomat. The website is your go-to. Make sure you're checking out the website constantly. You're going to find out all the members that are a part of the chamber. Chamber First is something that you're going to see a lot of in the communications, and that's the idea to promote business to each other from chamber members. And there's advertising opportunities on the as well through the website. The City Beautiful magazine is a beautiful publication, and I highly recommend that you check out the opportunity to advertise in that. It's distributed to all the businesses within the city of Coral Gables, and it's really a high quality piece. You may purchase mailing labels through the chamber, and I think in your first year, new members receive your first set of mailing labels at a 50% discount, and that might be a great opportunity right now to share your business with chamber members. And then there's also e-blast opportunities. And you've seen this probably over the last month if you've been involved with the chamber, that sometimes a business can sponsor an e-blast specifically to chamber members. Now I think I go to Kayla.
Yes. Hi, everyone. I'm Kayla Blake. I am the director of ticket sales for the University of Miami Athletics. So I handle all the sales for football, men's and women's basketball, and baseball. So I do about 180 events a year. So if you're interested in any Hurricane athletics, I can definitely help you with that. It's a very interesting time right now for us, as we know sports is not happening, which is very, I know the draft was very fun for us to watch last night because it was actually something to do in sports. But it'll be great whenever we can get up and running and having a way for you to be able to have your clients or your employees to come out to games as a thank you for going through this time and for staying with you. So if you have any questions with that, feel free to let me know. I am also the chair of the membership team for the chamber. So I handle all the new members and new member recognition, or if you have any questions about retaining or just anything in general for the chamber, I can help you with that. I'm also an ambassador and part of the Women's Business Committee. So I kind of do it all. So it's the best way to be a part, and I've been able to grow my business and myself. I actually changed careers about a few months ago, and a lot of it had to do with meeting people from the chamber. So it helped a lot with that. So chamber emails, you'll get daily emails, as I'm sure you make sure you add it to the safe list. If you haven't already, I'm sure you're going to get 3 or 4 emails a day, but it is a way to be able to stay on top of everything. And as Lauren mentioned, the City Beautiful magazine is a great way. So whenever you do get, well, you do get back, or you haven't already received it, I would definitely get a copy of that. I know they have some at the chamber office. It's going to have all of the businesses in the back who are chamber members. So you're able to see who else is part of the chamber. So you can, it's going to have their website and their address and the name of the representative. So it's going to help you in the sense of if you need to be able to connect with somebody, or in, if you want to do chamber first, meaning if you want to do business with other chamber members, which is essentially what we suggest. And then if you look at the difference, you have chamber chatter, chamber e-commerce, chamber connection, and event e-vites. As you can see, there's a lot of information in these, and you're going to get these weekly, some of them weekly, some of them monthly, and then the event e-vites you'll see multiple times. This is a way for you also, in some of these, you can highlight any upcoming events you have, and there's going to be the member-to-member discounts are listed in here, so it's a way for you to show your business too. If you have a deal going on that's for chamber exclusive, you can put the promo code or whatever link it may be in there as well, so everybody can see that. And then the event e-vites, if you want to sponsor a event, you'll see that it goes to all the members multiple times, and it's a way for your company to be listed as well. And then the chamber website is coralgableschamber.org. We also have Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, LinkedIn, YouTube, and then we have started a podcast called TroBiz, and it's a, I think they're on episode, this one's going to be episode 5, like they've done 4 episodes so far, so it'll be the 5th one. And it's a way that Mark Trowbridge, the president and CEO of the chamber, he features a chamber member, and they talk about what they do, and it's a really good connection and helps you learn about other people in the community in essential of all ways. And so make sure you check out the Facebook and the Instagram. I know those two are very popular, and there's a lot of pictures. They do a lot of highlighting of the events, really just to show what's going on for each event weekly. So special events, Burgerlicious. I don't know if any of you all were able to attend Burgerlicious in the past, but it's a great community event. It has a couple thousand people there. Last year I was the one with the burger on my head. I wore it at the entrance, so if you came by, it was pretty fun. It's at where we feature different restaurants, and they have a burger battle essentially, and you're able to walk around and see different vendors and different restaurants to really highlight Coral Gables restaurants. And it's a great thing, and a portion of the proceeds goes to the Coral Gables Community Foundation. And then, like I said, it's a very fun, it's always in November, and it's around November 8th, and I remember that because my birthday is November 8th, and it's either on my birthday or the day before usually on my birthday. So remember, it's in middle of the second week of November. And then the special event, this one was supposed to happen this month, so we will be delaying it. Doctors Hospital Tour of the Gables 5K and 10K. Awesome. I was OB, the Orange Bowl, at this last year, so I tend to have a thing of dressing things up at different events, so you might see that. But this is pretty fun. It's a way for you to get involved, and if you, even if you just want to walk with your family, or if your company wants to do a race, we do awards for companies, which is great because it's a corporate team, and we recognize them at the Chamber's breakfast, the winners of that, so that's a really neat thing to be able to have recognition that way. And then it's really a time for bonding, and you'll see a lot of groups still have matching t-shirts, and they do it together just because they want to be able to show, like last year, the board all had, they walked together and they had t-shirts, and you can just do different things like that. So it's a really good time. And then the chamber events. The chamber hosts well over 100 events, 8 of which will reoccur monthly. So that being Good Morning Coral Gables, that's going to be the 3rd Thursday of the month. And it is a very good event. It features, it has a lot, about 300 people that attend that. It's a very good breakfast event. A lot of people attend this that may not attend other events because of the timing. Just 7:30 in the morning, so it is kind of early. but it is a way for you to connect before you go to the office. The Reconnect Luncheon is the first Wednesday of the month, and it's held at Morton's. And that's by far my favorite event. You get your time at the mic where you get to actually say your name, what you do, what you're looking for, and it's a way for you to connect with, and it's a smaller group. It's about 50 people. Trono CEOs, this is where Mark Trowbridge features a CEO of a different company. This month, it's going to be Branches, and it's next Friday at 8:30 in the morning. So that's a good one to attend. Trustee Reception, this is a thing for trustee members. It's a free event that they have the first Tuesday of the month, and it's for them to connect, as well as the Trustee Luncheon. That's the last Tuesday of the month that they have that. The Women's Business Network Luncheon is a great, Flavia Equipause is actually a sponsor of that. And so it's a really good time. And yeah, we have Impact Seminar, and there's multiple other events that we have. And if you have any questions at all, feel free to let me know. You'll see events pop up, and make sure you're checking out all the virtual things right now. The annual events, we'll have the conference, the Global Groove, Chairman's Reception, Burgerlicious, as I mentioned, the 5K, 10K tour of the Gables, and the New Year's Networker. And there's lots of seminars and workshops right now through virtual. So just follow with your email, and if you have any questions, you can check Facebook or the website, and it'll all be there as well. So thank you guys for your time.
Awesome, Kayla, thanks. Kim, you want to put it back to the gallery? There we go. So I don't know, do you want just to unmute everybody and see what happens? If anybody has questions, it's probably the easiest way to do it, right? Anybody have any, I mean, we always cover a lot of ground on these presentations, mm-hmm. and I know it's a lot to absorb all at once, but I can tell you that we're all available anytime you want to reach out, you want to call, just general questions.
I want to ask, if I go to the website, in there I can see who I need to reach to see what, depending what committee I want to reach out to.
Absolutely. And committees, that's a good question. If you want to be on a committee, just watch the event calendar for the meetings. We're still doing committee meetings virtually, and show up to the meeting. There's no specific sign up. I mean, once you show up, the member of the staff who is the staff member associated with that committee can get your information and make sure you're included on the communications.
I don't need to pre-register in order to get the link, no?
Well, you yes. Actually, okay. Yeah.
Right, get the link, yes. For the meeting.
Right.
Right now, okay. Yes. For a link, yes. You register for that meeting. Or
who would I register with?
So Kim, I don't know if you or Yvette, if you can help with that. If someone...
Yeah, I mean, every committee is different. So just let me know if there's a committee you're interested in. Okay. I just attached in the chat the list of committees with all the descriptions. Feel free to peruse that and see what questions you have. And then if it's one that's open to all members, then just let me know, let any of our staff know, and we'll make sure we get you the Zoom invite.
Perfect. Thank you so much.
And Patrick, we, Belmont Village, I believe, are trustee members.
Correct.
Do we get separate emails on trustee events as well? Do they come in? Okay. All right. Yeah. So I can stay on top of those because I know we've been a member of the Coral Gables Chamber for a little while now. I'm just now myself personally starting to step in and get involved. So I've got to limit, Fort Lauderdale versus Coral Gables. So trustee is probably what I would be most interested in participating in at this time. So I just want to make sure I'm getting those emails, or will get them.
To make sure that Belmont has you listed as one of their delegates for the chamber. So
yep, believe I am.
Okay, then you should be getting those communications for all trustee level events.
Okay, sure. Thank you.
Any other questions?
No, thank you.
Great audience.
This is great. Actually, thanks.
I had a good question. What is the travel, what does that committee mean?
I actually think that the travel and tourism is probably more the one along the lines with the Greater Miami Visitor and Convention Bureau and the hotel associations. So they meet, like, it's a hospitality type committee. And I think it's met a couple times a year at least with Wendy from that association. And they They talk about tourism and how the hotels are impacted. I don't know, that might know a little bit more. I didn't go to the last meeting, but they meet as needed.
Yeah.
And they had a roundtable too.
Quarterly meetings, and their actual liaison is Mark Trowbridge. He's the person who runs that committee along with Matthias. But yeah, they meet quarterly, and I'll make sure to add you to the list so that the next meeting, be it virtual or in person, you're included, all right, Lee?
Thank you, appreciate it.
Okay.
Can you add me, sorry, to that as well?
Yeah.
That would be great.
All right.
Well, I think that, is that it? Anyone else? Like I said, you're welcome to reach out to myself, Kayla, Lauren, certainly Kim, Yvette. We're all here to help. We're just glad that you all have made the decision to join the Coral Gables Chamber. I really think that the benefits far outweigh the investment in the long run, as long as you stay engaged with us. Mm-hmm. And congratulations. I think we're all completing week 5 of social distancing measures. And let's hope we don't have too many more ahead of us. And I it's together that we're going to get through this. And I think the Chamber is one of the groups here in town that is making sure that we kind of stay on task and stay focused so that when we do emerge from all of this, we'll do it quickly and effectively and come out the other side as strong as we can. So any other comments? Lauren, Kayla, anyone?
Welcome, everybody. You made a great decision in joining the Coral Gables Chamber. So give yourselves a pat on the back.
There you go.
Wow. Thank you all.
Thank you, guys. Have a nice weekend.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, guys. Bye. Great meeting all you guys. Thank you.
Thanks.